Crypto right now is in a bearish market. We're seeing continuous downside momentum. We're also seeing this support area potentially failing. The next support area for Bitcoin is in this $20,000 level. We also have the FTX crypto portfolio having to be sold off, which is worth $3.4 billion. There is some potential of this $20,000 level being hit, and that's what we're going to take a look at in today's video. Smash the like, subscribe, leave a comment, and tap that notification bell to stay up to date with all of my latest videos. Make sure to check out this video description for my up-to-date trading masterclass that's currently 50% off, and you can sign up with the top global crypto exchange for a big sign-up bonus. So the latest crypto news that's showing this bearish momentum is FTX having to sell its $3.4 billion worth of crypto inside its portfolio. So the actual SEC and all of the court filings are basically concluding, and FTX is found to have $3.4 billion worth of crypto. And in order to pay back all of its people that deposited on the exchange, borrowers and lenders, all of these types of things, they're actually selling off their crypto portfolio to be able to pay back all of these people. And it's worth $3.4 billion. Currently, they're looking at, you know, we have $560 million worth of BTC. We actually have $1.1 billion worth of Solana. So potentially we will look at the price of Solana and see it is going to have some downside momentum. We also have $200 million worth of Ethereum. So overall, we do have a big portfolio having to be sold off. I believe it's going to go over the next 10 to 20 weeks where they sell around $200 million into that 3.4 is about 17 weeks. So they're going to sell consistently over the next 17 weeks, which potentially is showing that, especially when we come out into this longer term time frame, the next 17 weeks, because we are on a weekly time frame now, you know, comes out into this bar here. So it's basically saying to the start of next year, we're going to be downtrending until the start of next year. And then that's when this bull market is going to come. This is basically what it's saying. We're going to be trending, you know, in this type of market through here, even potentially just expand this out just a little bit more to even encapsulate some of these prices all through here. And potentially this is where we're going to be bouncing. We might have a bit of upside momentum, but definitely thinking that this $20,000 level could be the next area, because you actually look, where's the next support to resistance zone? When we look through here, we actually see that there was an initial resistance zone in here. We actually broke through it. You can see it right here. So initial resistance. We broke through, came back, retested it, and then we made these high prices. So we've got this zone in here, which nearly perfectly lines up with this $20,000 level. Not only that, there's a lot of stops in this level. People are putting their stops when they're trading up to these high prices. So we will have stops in this level. When people are entering longs down in this position, their stops are going to be below this level. So even if right now there aren't going to be stops in that area, that's where all of these stops in this area, when we do make these lower prices, are expected to come in. Next thing that we really look at is when we scroll in, we can see we are making a bit of a symmetrical triangle type of pattern here, and it's basically a form of a trading range where we get a big breakout in either direction, we move sideways, and then we get a continuation in whatever the initial breakout was. Upside, downside, doesn't matter. That's the high probability. Right now we got the downside breakout, we're getting that trading range, there's a high probability of that downside breakout. And what you can expect is probably one big break to the downside, and then we just slowly trickle for the next couple of weeks where we get a really strong break on one day, and then we just slowly move down. Now that we scroll in on Ethereum onto a daily chart, we can even see we're using this exponential moving average as this support, as this resistance zone. So every time we're actually coming up, since we got this big breakout to the downside, always looking for this value zone, putting a trade into this value zone, putting a maximum of 3% risk. So you look to enter on this 20 exponential moving average. Here you would have need 2% risk. If you had 3%, you would have been perfect. You can see then with that trade, you have that 2% risk, 3% risk. You're winning on this trade 6% down here, even up to here winning nearly 11%. So you've definitely got a really good risk to reward, 3-to-1, 2-to-1, you know, at least 2-to-1. That's really what you're looking for. You're just looking to take consistent trades over and over and over. So overall, we are expecting this bearish momentum overall coming into the market. There's going to be sellers. I was saying the other day that there is going to be more selling momentum in the market. It is unfortunate. And again, this is one of the support zones that it is going to come into. So let's even look at Solana now. Solana for the past month has definitely had big downside momentum. If we actually look from the top of this week, all the way from the top, all the way down nearly 50%. So Solana's had massive, massive downside momentum. Even in the last few days, basically the last 2 weeks, had huge downside momentum, massive play, would have been over 30%. Yeah, 30% right there. So overall, since we're having that $1 billion of Solana actually going to be sold off, you can see overall, we see the trend on the EMA trending to the downside. What we look for is we look for trades when we come back into this value zone, because the goal is to be selling high and to be buying low. Rather than be selling in this area, that would be selling low. And then you'd be looking to buy back high. That would be the opposite. You want to be selling high and buying low. And that's what I'm looking in my position right here in the value zone, since we've got the downtrend on the EMA. Enter right as we hit the 20 exponential moving average, put 2%, 3% risk, and then you take the trade. On this trade, wouldn't needed much risk. If you put 3%, perfect. And then on that trade, look, you're making 12%. If you made it all the way to the bottom, making 20%. So massive, massive risk to rewards. Just got to be continuously taking the trade. Looking for the actual momentum in the slope of the EMA. Come back into the value zone, as I'm saying, selling high and buying low. Then you buy, you sell your position high because you're shorting in the market. Then you obviously buy back low to continue your position. So, and then even in here, we come back into the value zone again. You just put a couple of percent risk, then you trade it to the downside, 14%. You put 2 or 3% risk, 14% to the downside, massive, massive momentum. So obviously you just want to be trading it, but obviously expecting that more downside momentum. Even when we come out to the weekly chart, I don't even like this very much. When we come out to the weekly chart, what I'm actually seeing is sideways momentum in here, where we're in a form of a trading range where people are actually buying low in the bottom 25% of this trading range, and they're selling high in the top 25%. People are selling high, selling high, selling high. When we come back into this value zone, people are ready to buy, and expecting right now even a big break continuation to the downside in this area, and then buying back in this area again. I do expect there to come buyers back, but right now there is more downside momentum. The next 14 weeks, so we can even, let's again project this, the next 14 or so weeks coming into this area would give price enough time to make a bit of a bounce and then come back into this area. Come back looking to buy in the bottom 25%. I'd truly be looking to personally buy Solana at around that $12 range. So if we even look at the percentage drop from the current price, that would be roughly another 30% drop. So not only have we had a 30% drop in the last couple of weeks, we'll have another 30% drop to the downside. That's when I'm personally looking to buy Solana. So overall, you just need to have a plan. Obviously not financial advice, but again, that's why you want to look at multiple timeframes. I really love the daily time frame, but my favorite time frame is actually the weekly. And because I really like the weekly, it allows me to really zoom out and to find these real long-term positions, because I'm just not looking for 1 and 2% to the upside. I'm looking for these big 60-70% swings. I'm looking for a double on my money. I'm not just looking for a 1 and 2% gain, 0.3% in and out 10 times a day, paying basically all of my trades in commission. I'm looking for high probabilistic trades where I have a really good risk to reward, but I'm also trading on these longer term time frames, because if I'm trading on the 1 minute, I can't go for a 10% gain because the 1 minute chart doesn't offer 10% gains. But when I'm trading the weekly and the daily chart, they offer those longer term trades. It gives me time to actually do other business ventures, to actually travel, to actually make different videos, to create content for TikTok, Twitter, YouTube, and allows me not only to just be staring at the charts 15 hours every single day. I can spend a couple hours every single day on the charts, and then a couple of hours also building businesses and building different sources of income. Smash the like, subscribe, leave a comment, and tap that notification bell to stay up to date with all of my latest videos. Check out this video description for my trading masterclass and top global crypto exchange. And if you'd like to continue watching my YouTube videos, click the one that's on this screen right now.